is NBC 15 News at 6.
Now at 6, a local community remembers a fallen soldier lost in an enemy attack on his convoy. Tonight, many in Waterloo are mourning the loss of Lieutenant Colonel Paul Bart.
He's one of 5 soldiers killed in the deadliest attack in Afghanistan in 8 months. NBC 15's Chris Woodard was in Waterloo today, and he's here with more.
John, those who knew Bart call him a natural leader. They say he was always looking out for other people. It's a reputation that only grew stronger as he worked his way up to a top military position.
Flags at Waterloo's Veterans Memorial fly at half staff today. The memory of 43-year-old Lieutenant Colonel Paul Bart's fresh in many minds.
It's been real tough. I mean, fight back tears.
Dick Jones knew Bart's well.
This would be a senior year.
He's a former teacher, and the two grew close in recent years. Tuesday night, he got the bad news. Bart's is one of 5 soldiers killed in the Afghan capital of Kabul, apparently among 18 people killed by a suicide car bombing on Tuesday.
They got the wrong guy. He had lived in that part of the world. He appreciated the culture, the history. I mean, if this thing was ever going to work out positive for both sides, he was one of the guys that you needed, and now he's gone.
Bart's is survived by his wife and son.
Many in this small city have been shocked by the news. We talked to one relative who said Paul was doing what he loved to do. He called him a great person and said he would do anything for anyone.
Number 14.
Former teachers and coaches remember Bart's as the star linebacker and quarterback, member of the basketball team, and prom king.
When you talk about a hometown boy, this was somebody that was from Waterloo.
I knew the high school young man really well, and he was just an excellent young man. He was a very intelligent, very hardworking, and was people first. I mean, he's just a great young man.
A great young man that Jones saw grow into a great leader. He says would modestly joke he was just a guy from Waterloo.
Paul, you were one of the smart people, and
in a city where the patriotism is easy to see, this hero will be remembered not only for who he was, but the great man he became and the sacrifice he gave.
The Taliban have claimed responsibility for the attack, saying one of their operatives based in Kabul was driving the suicide vehicle.